First of all, namaste and good morning to everyone. Thank you very much, Vinit and Sania, for the introduction and taking us through the entire list of the proud winners. Congratulations to each and every winner. I'm sure it's a special day for everyone, and so is for me. Well, I would like to begin with first saying thank you very much for inviting me over today to be a part of this valedictory event. And this is more special being an alumni of this beautiful Institute of Hotel Management and Catering Technology Applied Nutrition Goa. I myself am a pass out of this institute in 1997. That's the batch which I passed out from and graduated. It is not only an honor to be amongst each and every one of you, but also a privilege that I am here representing the institute and joining this screen with each and every one of you. That holds a very remarkable presence of giving the hospitality industry so many talents that have made a mark and contributed to this beautiful travel and hospitality industry that we are all part of or going to be part of. Having said this, and frankly speaking, my family also owes to this institute a lot. Three of our family members, which include me, my sister, my brother-in-law, we all graduated from this beautiful campus, and of course from various batches. But most importantly, it's not just us from this field and fraternity. In my family, we have another FOMO who are already part of this beautiful industry, which is hotels and hospitality. And of course, each one of doing and managing their own day-to-day activity, and of course have done well and are growing to be and to take part of many such opportunities that are there in this industry. And mostly, it's not just stopping with our generation. The next generation, which also includes my nephew, is pursuing hotel management. So that is how close this beautiful industry and hospitality is to each and every one of us. And of course, I'm really proud to be sharing all of this because I'm part of you, I'm one of you. And how I see each and every one of you, some of course through screens, and of course I see Sania and of course Vinit, the way they have been speaking, the confidence level, it really kind of motivates me and kind of reminds me of my graduation time when I was part of this institute and going through my career opportunity and course through hotel management. I thank Mrs. Donna D'Souza, who has been a professor not just to me, but also to the three of us in our family. And if you look at her, she doesn't seem to age. I don't know how you do that, ma'am, but I'm sure it comes with a lot of passion, with a lot of smile, and with a lot of energy that she keeps and drives within herself. But yes, having said that, very importantly, through this, she continues to motivate and inspire many of the budding hospitality professionals, and of course, runs such a beautiful institute that holds so much respect and value in this industry. I thank her and all the professors. I, of course, had a chance to interact with, Mr. Sunil Chauhan, who's been my professor as well. He's an HOD, of course, there. And I also heard the name Tina, which also kind of reminds me that, yes, it kind of reminds me of my college days when I was there. And all of them were there, helping us to groom and shape ourselves into the career opportunities that we picked up post-graduating from the institute. Well, this institute, I could say, is all about passion. I'm sure you heard this many times, but it is true. You have to have that passion. And most importantly, the smile. Because this is something which will remain with you and this will always be around with you. And of course, with these two with you, your passion and the smile, sky is the limit. And that is the best that I can share with each and every one of you. Because when I look back, way back in 1997, I was at the same spot as you as today, and quite a few of you who are also going to be there very soon. For me, frankly, since I was told to speak about my journey, I started my career after passing out in 1997. I had my first opportunity to join a project site in Goa as management trainee. And of course, we did not know what it is going to shape into, but it ended up and shaped up to become the first Marriott hotel in the country, which also gave me another opportunity to further pursue another pre-opening opportunity with the same group, which is the Renaissance in Mumbai. I also had the opportunity to spend 5 years with the Taj, where I had the opportunity to groom myself into a managerial role at the Taj Holiday Village, then at the Taj President, and finally at Taj Exotica. I took my first administrative role way back in 2007. And this was a role which also came with a lot of challenges. I did not know how, but you know, with what you have within yourself, you just have to carry along your experience, your exposure, and what you have learned from the past, whether it was from the education or whether it was from the practical knowledge that you gained through your industrial training opportunity, or whether it was on ground experience that you had. I had my first opportunity to spearhead a pre-opening. I don't know, you being in Goa, probably if you have traveled around Kandolin, I'm sure all of you have done. It was a very small, beautiful resort called Lemon Tree Amaranthi Beach Resort. So way back in 2006 and 7, I had my first opportunity to spearhead a 65 rooms boutique hotel and spearhead that pre-opening. With that came another opportunity to move to another state where the next exposure came by. This was 130 rooms, Lemon Tree, Chennai, doing my third pre-opening as the administrative head. This was the Raintree Hotel. This was, of course, a five-star deluxe hotel. And most importantly, it came with its own unique USPs or unique selling proposition, which was to be the first eco-tel and first eco-sensitive hotel in South India. Again, this inventory was 236 rolls. And since then, way back in 2013, I managed to get into Accor. Speaking about Accor, this is the company which I currently represent. Accor manages more than 5,000 hotels globally. We speak of more than 10,000 plus food and beverage outlets and dining opportunities. I speak of 30 brands that we manage from luxury to economy. And of course, it set sail its presence in India way back in 2006. And since then, and South Asia, which includes Sri Lanka, and we manage 9 brands to speak of. We are practically more than 3 lakh plus artists that we call ourselves. And why do we call ourselves artists rather than calling us associates and employees and anything else? Because we believe that whatever we do it from the bottom of our hearts and we do it with a smile. And that is why we call ourselves artists. Like how I'm sure as part of the college just now, all of you are called cool cats because you guys are cool, right? You guys are at the age where things are all cool. So obviously we call ourselves and address ourselves an artist. And believe me, it makes I thank Mrs. Donna for giving me this opportunity to be amongst all of you and allowing me to share this platform with her and the professors who taught me. But I'm sure this is only to motivate each of you and to share, because there are many in the industry, and definitely they want to see you grow, they want to see you flourish, and they want you to make a mark for yourself. The last that I would like to say that at Accor, we believe in be limitless and live limitless. So this is something that I want to leave a thought to all of you, and make sure that we get a chance to interact sometime if you are within the industry, and make sure that we connect more, we could share more. I am definitely available at this beautiful hotel for you to connect. And I also look forward that many of you, if not someone today, in probably the batches coming up, look forward to make their careers also with Accor. I did share what we bring on the table. We bring in a lot of learning opportunities, and this is something which will never stop. So be limitless and keep smiling is all that I can say at this point in time. And thank you, Donna ma'am. Thank you, Chavan sir. Thank you, Tina ma'am, if you all here and listening. We definitely owe you as students. And if there is anything for us, we are always available. Thank you very, very much, ma'am. And thank you to all the students. Good luck and best wishes.
We have with us Ms. Siddhi Shintre, a student from the graduating batch, who would like to share her thoughts, her blissful journey and experience at the institute. Over to you, Siddhi.
Thank you, Sanya. Hello everyone, my name is Siddhi and I would like to extend my warm welcome to the chief guest, to the principal, to the teachers in attendance and my fellow graduating class of 2020. We find ourselves in a rather unique position this year, not knowing whether we are the luckiest or the unluckiest. We are a graduating class that hasn't written our exams, hasn't had a farewell or even a regular graduation ceremony. Most of us may think that we are on a deserted island all by ourselves, but we really are not. There are over a million students that are graduating from the class of 2020, all ready to sail their own ship, alone yet together. I would like to share with you my journey of the past 3 years. After my 12th standard, I joined BSc to become a scientist. A year after which, I took a drop to pursue the pathway my heart lay. I joined IHM and I realized that I was a year older than most of my peers, which made me feel as though I was in a race against time and against my own batchmates. In my third year, in order to outdo all my peers, I took up an internship. For a year, I juggled with my third year academic commitments and my internship, at the end of which it left me exhausted, overwhelmed, and without a social life. It's when I realized that I needed to take things slowly, pace myself out, and most importantly, that my race is against my own barriers. And hence, I should concentrate more on myself. And yes, lastly, this year, we might not have flowers or graduating caps, our parents or our teachers here with us in person. But what we do have is the most special graduation ceremony, because never before have so many gathered from their living rooms, from their bedrooms, and some of you may even be joining us from your workspaces. Lastly, that being said, I would say we all have our own journeys to make and or to figure out, and figuring it out does take time. Just remember that there is luck and opportunity waiting for all of us, and it's just a matter of time. Lastly, I'd like to say that a part of this institution shall always remain with me, and a part of me shall always belong to this institution. Thank you and congratulations to the graduating class of 2020.
Bye. Thank you, Siddhi, for sharing your experience with us. All the very best. We also have videos of other students who would like to share their experiences with us. So let's hear them out.
Hello everyone, I hope you all are safe and healthy. Talking about my experience with IHM Goa, I suppose it is the most unique thing that has ever happened to me. Getting to know all the different people, making friends and having a good time is something which we all are gonna miss. I would also like to thank all the faculty members who always supported me and stood by me and for all their efforts. I wish success on each and every student and I hope we all excel no matter where we are. And maybe someday we could sit together and, you know, smile back at all the things that we did. Have a great time, everyone. Hello, everyone.
So we have another video. I'll share the screen again.
Congratulations everyone, batch of 2017 to 2020, for finally finishing the third year after so many ups and downs this year. Our 3 years at IHM Goa have helped us grow in so many ways, while learning how to survive without eating roti, while learning how to finish assignments and journals at record-breaking speeds, while learning how to survive with only a few hours of sleep during exam seasons. Somewhere along the line, we learned a little more about life and met so many amazing people along the way. I would like to thank each and every one of you who helped make my journey a little bit more special. And I hope you remember to thank yourself for being able to survive this. I wish you all a very, very happy life ahead and good luck for your future. Congratulations.
A big part of who I am as a professional today was taught at IHM. When I think about who we were when we came to this college with expectations, ambitions, we didn't really know what to expect. It was remarkable how we grew through our college and became who we are today. I think IHM is an experience that in simple words cannot be described. There was so much to do, so much to experience, so much to achieve, and only in 3 years. And every time we think about it, we go back there, we miss it. We miss the freedom we had, we miss the times we spent in our cafeteria, waiting for our friends, talking about the day, tired from all the practicals in the morning, then getting ready for the even tiring and boring theory lectures. There were headaches, there were failures, there was laughter, there was everything. I mean, it was like going into another world when we entered the college. And we still miss that college, and most of us would give anything to go back to that college. If you hear from anybody, you would hear completely different stories, completely different perspectives about the college. But we all, somewhere or the other, feel the same way. Not because of the place, not because of the building, but because of the people, because of our faculty, because of the diversity that we found of people coming from across the country. And for all of it to end so suddenly at the end was much tougher than we imagined. But then also, I'm happy that I didn't have to cry in front of the college for farewell, you know. I would like to say all the best to all my colleagues. I would like to thank my teachers. I would say that most of the time that I spent in the college was made better because most of the teachers.